Over the past 2 years, you've likely taken a COVID rapid antigen test, and you probably know what to do. Swab, swirl, and wait for results. A unique biochemical reaction involving saline, tiny particles of gold, and paper with antibodies is helping to give us quick and relatively accurate results.
Never felt more attractive in my life. Okay, 3, 4 pieces of me, 5.
Today, Kate is taking a COVID test while explaining the biochemical reactions.
Mississippi. I'm gonna go the other way. Okay, now I'm gonna do the disgusting thing and stick this in the back of my throat. Ugh. Okay, that's all I can do. All right. An epidemiologist named Michael Mina, he is strongly suggesting for this particular variant, for Omicron, that you swab in the back of your throat and your nose if you're gonna do the rapid test. And so we're just looking for the highest viral load. Some people are swabbing their nose and getting a negative, and then they swab their throat and getting a positive, and that is just supporting the fact that Omicron is definitely living in our throat. We are having a high viral load there, and it's more easily detected if you swab there.
Once we've collected our sample, the chemistry starts to begin. And molecular forces take our sample in a buffer solution.
So the buffer solution is almost entirely salt water. And so it's like 99.7% salt water, which is really sodium chloride in water. On top of that, we have a conjugate acid and a conjugate base. And so these are two different versions of a phosphate molecule. One is called sodium hydrogen phosphate, and the other one is called potassium dihydrogen phosphate. And they lock the solution's pH into about a pH of 7.4.
This is where the chemistry comes in. The acid and the base in the buffer solution create a conjugate acid-base pair.
A conjugate acid and base are two different molecules that are almost identical except for one hydrogen atom. So one piece has the hydrogen atom, one piece does not. And buffer solutions are resistant to big changes in pH. So if an acid comes along, the conjugate base is going to eat that up and keep it at a pH of 7.4. If a base comes in, the conjugate acid is going to eat that part up and again lock the pH in at 7.4.
That pH of 7.4? The same pH as our blood, helping to mimic the conditions of the human body.
1, 2, 3, 4. Beautiful.
Now that our sample is locked in with a pH of 7.4, we can see whether we are positive or negative. And that tiny spot where it says S? That's where nanoparticles of gold reside.
Such a tiny amount of gold in there. You couldn't sell it, you cannot see it, you can't turn it into a necklace or anything. It is absolutely minuscule. The gold is connected to an antibody, and so there's kind of like a chunk of gold and an antibody right here. And if that N protein from the COVID virus is present in the specimen, antibody one is gonna reach out and grab it.
Those antibodies are immune responses to a specific antigen.
An antigen is the part of the virus that is easily distinguishable. So technically pollen could be an antigen. Any foreign body that comes into your body could be an antigen. But a lot of times we talk about it in the context of a virus. And so if gold nanoparticle plus antibody one plus COVID virus goes up to that T level, antibody two now reaches out and grabs onto that COVID virus and locks it into place. So you've got gold, antibody one, COVID, and then antibody two stuck on that T line, and now boom, you've got a color change. So a positive test is gonna happen right away. As soon as that gold nanoparticle reaches that T level and the antibody grabs onto the COVID virus, you're going to see that color change. Now a negative test is essentially a lack of a positive test. And so what we're doing is just making sure that in that allotted time, that T level never changes colors.
Now there are some caveats as to how accurately your test results come in.
Number one would be if you swabbed correctly. Lab scientists are getting the best results because they know exactly how to perform these tests, followed by healthcare workers, they're second, and then the third is the regular, the rest of us that are just at home doing that. Second thing that could detect your test is your viral load. So how much of that virus is actually sitting in your body.
And there's also ways people cheat the test. In fact, a few TikToks have shown tests with Coca-Cola Zero Sugar, strawberry juice, or Monster Energy get a positive result.
These rapid tests are very pH sensitive. That's why we use the buffer to lock our sample into a pH of 7.4. If we start introducing something like soda, which has a pH around 3, or something like juice, which has a pH around 4, you're going to immediately mess with the pH of your sample, and that's going to completely negate the result of the test. And you might get a false positive, you might get a false negative, but it's just definitely not accurate. So parents out there, if your kid is cheating by using soda or something to get a false positive to get out of class, class, the best way you can figure that out is grab that original buffer solution, shake it over that T-line, and if it was messed with, if soda or juice was used, you're going to immediately see it switch back and you'll get the accurate result, which would likely be a negative. Now, for the first time, everybody, no matter who you are, what you look like, what your gender is, you are actually going through these at-home tests, and I think that's really valuable and kind of neat that we're all at-home scientists. I truly hope we use this technology to move forward with the flu. That would be my goal. If we could use this every single season, if you think you have the flu, test yourself before you go outside, wear a mask still. I would love to see that moving forward because that's just going to be incredibly helpful for our public health.